recipe is a very interesting recipe. So many of you have asked for this and requested it. So today I've finally decided to show it to you. This is gobi fried rice. So why wait? Let's get started and check it out. For the cauliflower fried rice, I've taken one medium-sized cauliflower. I've cut into small florets. I've washed it clean. So make sure you wash it nice and clean. To this, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of salt, 3 teaspoons of Kashmiri chili powder, freshly crushed pepper. Next, add 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste. Mix everything together. Now that the cauliflowers are coated with the masala, now I'm going to add 2 teaspoons of rice flour. Next, add 3 teaspoons of corn flour. Mix it together. Let it sit for about 10 minutes before shallow frying. For shallow frying, take a white pan, add enough oil for shallow frying the cauliflowers. So make sure the oil is nice and hot. Slowly start placing the cauliflowers into the oil. After placing the cauliflowers into the hot oil, don't mix them or disturb them too much. Let it cook for about 5 minutes on medium-high flame. So now you can see the flour is stuck to the cauliflowers beautifully. It's coated well. The cauliflowers are cooked, so gently remove them from the oil and keep it aside. To make the fried rice, take 1 tablespoon of oil to a pan. To this, I'm going to add 3 large cloves of finely chopped garlic, piece of finely chopped ginger, next add 1 medium-sized onion finely chopped, saute for about a minute. Next, I'm going to add 1 small capsicum, cut into small pieces. Stir fry the vegetables for about 2 minutes. Season it, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, freshly crushed pepper, 1/2 teaspoon chili flakes, mix everything. Now add 1 teaspoon of soy sauce, reduce the flame, 3 teaspoons of chili sauce, 1 teaspoon vinegar, mix everything. So if you need extra sauce, either soy sauce or chili sauce, you can add extra depending on the quantity of rice or vegetables that you're using. Add the cooked rice. For this recipe, I'm using long grain basmati rice. Check for seasoning after adding the sauces, and if you need to add anything extra for a better flavor, you can do so. I'm going to add some spring onion whites to give it a little crunch, a few spring onion greens. Finally, add the cauliflowers. So gently mix it all together. The gobi fried rice is done. It looks absolutely fantastic. I can't wait to have a bowl of this. Make sure you serve it nice and hot. Here is this delectable gobi fried rice. It's a very simple recipe. It makes for a good lunchbox recipe as well. So do try it and enjoy. You can get a copy of our first edition of the home cooking book on 21 Quinn.